allowed them the time to use that teleport strat. The lane phase is simply not last long enough.
We'll see what they have each other in picks and bans. Quick, two killers coming out of that ban list. Vayne and Annie. We have not seen Annie, and it hasn't changed for Royal. Sanja casting every single time.
Pretty staple bans coming in Royal. They're very comfortable with those bans. They did all three games, but now Orianna is left open, and
absolutely.
It does. Yep. Fnatic pick Orianna up.
It has to, had to happen. Pick Orianna because they've been losing to it twice from whites, and we know Peke is an extremely strong Orianna. These are actually kind of expected pick bans so far. You know Fnatic was expecting that.
Yep. And again, we see the Renekton at least coming out of Royal. The Renekton actually didn't do as well as we thought we'd do. Right. Godlike is an amazing Renekton player, world renowned for it. But he didn't actually do that well again, so as Zach last game. Elise, solid pick by Lucky, he's doing pretty well on it. Although the Aatrox by Cyanide previously did pretty well against Lucky when he caught him out in that top lane, so we'll see if he can pull it off again.
Yeah, Cyanide really stepped up on Aatrox, and it was just the lanes that ended up letting him down a little bit. Fnatic this time, if they can have better control of that mid lane, could allow Cyanide to maybe snowball a bit harder, because Peke did fine in the Zach matchup last game.
Yep. It's going to be interesting to see what the response is here from White. And it looks like he is going for the Fizz. I feel he's calling he's calling Peke right here if he locks his Fizz in.
That is interesting.
Oh, defaulting back to Gragas.
I'd say a little too dangerous to be playing Fizz on this one. Possibly, but it's up to White. These guys like to pull out what they can, when they can. And this is the game they would do it. There has to be a release of pressure here, obviously, for Royal, with this being game point.
Well, one thing you have to realize is Orianna does really well against that double revive comp of Aatrox and Zac. Gragas does not do so well because you let out your burst, but then you don't have that kind of sustained damage and utility that Orianna does have. So I think it would be interesting to see if he actually does pick the Gragas or not. We'll see if it goes.
I would actually be very happy right now if I'm Fnatic, knowing that you have a Lulu with a Corki support, because there's no, since the Vayne is banned, no Vayne hyper carry to worry about. Corki, while he has strong mid game and that's what Royal excels in, will now be a little more vulnerable to Fnatic lockdown. Fnatic has more of an AoE composition, and White's is more about saving a single target. So I do like Fnatic's picks and bans the most of the three games in this one.
I would also like to highlight the fact that Uzi picked up cleanse against Leona this time. I think it's very integral against that Leona matchup as he picks up the cleanse. And we also see the Lulu backups to protect the Uzi comp again. Lulu is really, really good at doing that. So it should be the thing is there's less outplaying in this lane, I feel. I feel it's going to be a little more passive than this Ezreal matchup that was before.
We've actually seen in both games different setups in the lanes. We've seen the 2v1 and we've seen the 2v2. And the 2v2 actually worked better coming in for Fnatic. However, they weren't able to win. It was a Lulu lane that they 2v1'd against. So as a Zac, pressuring with Glitterlance, killing him almost under tower. So maybe Cyanide won't get a chance to be in a different lane.
I think it's very important to note here that this is the fastest pick and ban phase we've also had. These guys flew through
they
the
know
champion
what they
select.
Want.
They knew exactly what they want. I mean, after two games against each other, with the last game being the closest of the three, I do feel like Fnatic, even though it was quick picks and bans, came out on top.
I feel like, especially we see Fnatic roster right here, outside of their typical Kassadin and Lissandra combos, I think this is one of their most comfortable champion sets to run. Going for the Gragas, I'm not entirely sure how this Gragas is going to pay off. Hopefully Peke can stand up to White in lane this time. And I think if he does, it's going to shine out too.
Yeah, and also, that's the third AD carry that Pushu switched to now. Is he just desperate to try and find something that's going to work?
I think it worked out so poorly for him in the last game that at least now with Varus, he can combo with Leona. We've seen that combination fairly frequently before. Mm. It has been strong and worked for him, and I think it was also his most played AD carry during the regular season, and he's going back to comfort when it matters most.
And we have to touch on that, but right now, Snoopy, thank you very much for coming up here in Game 3. I know you want to see a Game 4 coming out, so best of luck there. Right now, we are going to put it into Game 3 for us, and it is going to be a huge one. We will see you back for Game 4. I think so.
I'll do. Hope so.
Hope so.
Come on, Fnatic.
So looking at those lanes, we're talking a little about Puju. We're talking about Uzi. We have to talk about mids as well. There's so much time to do it. So let's start in the bottom lane. Talking about Uzi, talking about Puju. With three changes in a row, like you just said, we've seen Royal bringing out champions consistently each game. The comfort level has to change.
Yeah, Royal does seem very confident. And their comfort level isn't thrown off too much by this. The teleport strategy not being brought out by Fnatic. I think the discussion we had about them losing lanes means Fnatic's number one priority is to stop the bleeding there, and then they'll worry about pulling off a teleport strategy. Until then, Fnatic's just got this last chance.
And more importantly, let's see if there's any level one engagements, because they have not gone well for Fnatic so far. Royal Club just know how to fight at level one.
Yeah, I know. In game one, they ran into each other with five people on each team and backed away. Game two, we saw the 3-for-1 kill. These guys are on a collision course for each other.
And they don't want that brush. They got the warden that they needed, but Royal will still continue to walk forward. That, this.
Can they catch one?
Right here.
On the backside.
Oh, they don't want it. First, the spider's going to see him. Godlike's going to be hit up. Who is it they're going for? That's going to be the focus target. Looking maybe. Whites, he's got the Ignite burning. He's going to get away from that one. Cyanide's passive has been burned. The Ignite will not get Whites down. Yellowstar should be able to lock up his cooldown. We'll be back in a moment. We see the defensive ball on him. But again.
Wow.
Nobody goes down. Crazy stuff.
There were three flashes burned by Royal. Two Ignites burned by Fnatic. But how do they get away with that? Five people with Godlike being the first into the brush and not dying. I feel like Royal dodged a bullet there.
And this is huge, considering up to 6 minutes now, you're gonna have three lanes without flash. Cyanide can have a ball. He changed up that play style, curbed farming in the jungle, and we saw him a lot more in lane, so it could have a big effect.
Exactly, he's gonna have to get very aggressive, but we have to remember last game, one of the things that slingshotted him ahead of Lucky was Lucky's aggression onto Cyanide and Cyanide's ability to then punish that. At this point, actually, Royal is maybe going to play defensively in lanes, which could have the biggest impact of all, because that would mean Pushu may not fall behind as far and farm from Uzi. We do see that 2v2, and we know if Yellowstar gets that Zenith Blade on Itabe, there's no flash to escape.
Well, you're saying that, but Cyanide's Bloodwell was popped, so he can't go overly aggressive. We'll see how it works out for them in that lane. And as you mentioned, this time around, Pushu cannot get bullied in that lane. You can already see Yellowstar's trying to beat that big man up front, trying to keep him at bay, but Pushu is already taking bursts of damage.
I like what Fnatic has actually done here. We were saying that Soaz had a hard time against this Glitterlands Lulu. All that damage, Peke finding a little bit there, and it was actually Body Slam taken first by Whites here. Going pretty hard.
Extremely aggressive early laning, even without flash. Body slamming into Peke once he had level 2 is just the risky way that Royal plays League of Legends. They guessed right there, knowing that Cyanide's Bloodwell is down, that he would not be camping at level 2 for a gank. And because Whites was pushing the lane early, he got the harass trade down.
And already, look at this. The top lane. It's starting to happen already, isn't it? 11-5 CS, keeping that pressure. All the time, Royal just keeps shoving onto the turret.
We know they're shoving, but I'm not willing to call this an advantage yet. It's level 2 to level 2. There's a huge wave stacked up for Pushu to get back into it. Pushu should be able to turtle this one out. I don't think Uzi has taken a big advantage yet because Pushu and Yellowstar still have a lot of health. They haven't taken too much harass.
I see Godlike has his lane pressured in the bottom as well. So with all of these lanes, Cyanide has a bit to think about. Looks like his mind is teetering towards the lower half of the map, but every image of Royal is on a turret of Fnatic on that mini-map right now.
Well, we see Whites and Peke in his mid lane. Whites has that Ignite available, and Peke is well aware of it, sticking off at the side this time around. He's keeping up close this time. Remember, there was no kills at the start, despite the fact for the third game running, we've had very aggressive plays from these two teams. No advantage gained. Bloodwell will be back available shortly for Cyanide. It is like a 3-minute cooldown, I believe it is, overall. We expect to see around about this now, 4-minute mark, he's going to be looking to come to one of those lanes and see if we can help out. Looks like it might be the top.
At least early on as well, Cyanide chose to farm the jungle, whereas Lucky tried his hand at ganking. He was actually up in that top lane rush about 30 seconds ago, thinking that Cyanide would try a gank for Pushu and Yellowstar, because that has been the general gank focus of Cyanide in the first two games. But switching it up a little bit, obviously, Fnatic with Peke on Orianna, less of an assassin-based team, not really worried about catching the picks early on in the game. And for the first time, they are laning quite evenly right now. 100 gold difference about 5 minutes into the early laning phase.
And seeing the whole time with the aggression and skill that come from Whites and Peke throughout that laning phase, they just do not fight each other. It's either the respect or the knowledge of where to position, but that lane stays safe, and this allows Cyanide and Lucky to kind of hit the outer lanes. We're seeing now soaking up mid experience, but there is no pressure being relieved here by Royal. They are still at every turret.
Keeping the pressure on, they're gonna lock on towards Uzi. Have they got enough to lock him down? Cleanse was already used out there, pushing force to back away by Tabe. A good trade overall between both teams.
And Tabe actually has his Ignite still. He saved it for that one, whereas Yellowstar's is down. This actually gives Royal a bit of an edge if Yellowstar decides to go in again. I don't know if Yellowstar is going to account for that. Not very frequently do you see a Lulu with Ignite, especially when the AD carry has Cleanse. You're much more likely to see an Exhaust for defensive purposes.
Whoa, Yellowstar just on the outside of that one, holds the Zenith Blade in his pocket, and it looks like they're gonna get a little bit of control on that lane. Here's that Sway and CS coming back as Uzi Gonna have himself back for a purchase, going for that Phage first, but Soaz, he's taking a little bit of aggression in the bottom lane.
This is a lane that's impressed me actually from Soaz, because you know, obviously God, like, he's famed for this Renekton. We always wondered what he was gonna use to counter it. We've talked about the Jax earlier on getting going in one of the matches before, but so far Soaz, as like game two, he has put up a really good fight against Godlike, and he was the one that got going in game two.
Yeah, and Fnatic is very defensively farming right now across all lanes. Godlike has been pushed up beyond the halfway point. White's just actually used his ultimate in the mid lane to keep Peke pushed back a little bit. And Cyanide hasn't been ganking out of that, but with all of that being considered, the lanes, while they're slightly tiltering in Royal's favor, are not nearly as bad as they were in the previous match.
Not looking good for Godlike. Bad news bears as he goes into this one. It's also going to be Soaz. First Blood's looking to come up on the screen, and they're going to chalk this one up for who? It goes to Cyanide.
And now, because there's two people in the top lane and Peke hurts White's in the mid lane, it's a huge amount of advantages for Fnatic.
Big pressure from Fnatic. That could be the dragon for them. We do see Lucky just lingering to see if he can fancy his chances. His smites have been on point so far, but he doesn't feel that confident up against four members of Fnatic.
And right there was just an early preemptive rotation by Fnatic to get back there. And Lucky, he's got to get out of that brush.
He was hatching a ward, and he was about to get taken out. 7 minutes in, a very quick dragon coming from Fnatic. And they are definitely putting their foot down and making a mark early in this game.
Oh, blue buff invade as well coming out from Fnatic here. We see Cyanide in there, Yellow Stars with him. And they're going to try and take that away, but they're going to trade this top turret because Soaz was back away. He may get it back in there just in time. I'm not too sure, though. Uzi's putting damage down.
If we think about it big picture, this top lane turret going down was traded for the first Blood Gold and the Dragon, which if we add up is about 1,600 overall gold for Fnatic, whereas that turret is only 750. As long as Fnatic doesn't run into a similar situation as they did in game two, where they lose three or four turrets before they get one in return, it is a fantastic trade for Fnatic.
That's finally the way they need it to fall in their favor. The kills, then the advantages of structures and moving around to grab map control. 8 minutes in, it's only a 500 gold lead, but that dragon helps them out. Oh, the cocoon locks him up. Lucky gets the safety. It looks like they may re-engage.
Yeah, they are outnumbered though in their blue buff right now. No, they're not. Yeah, so Fnatic is the one doing the outnumbering. I was thinking that Yellowstar is far from home. He's actually leaving Pushu alone in the bottom lane against Godlike, which is putting a lot of faith in a little old Varus against a monster crocodile.
That is Royal. They're trying their best to counter it, trying to get that blue buff back. It wasn't really close enough for Whites. We do still see Lucky. Look, he's lingering just around at the side. They're going to try and come in. He's going to force him to try and smite this one away. Not going to happen. Cyanide does get the other one. Actually, that was Peke that picked up the blue buff, I believe.
No. I believe that Cyanide is the one who smited it away.
Yep.
So it was a successful invade by Lucky, keeping Peke down a little bit. Peke, while he's doing well in lane, is still not outplaying Whites, especially melee versus ranged, also getting his jungle stolen away by the fat man right there. It's not
good. He's in a bad spot. Oh, he flashes the shockwave out. Only have a couple seconds to do that, but he does get that down. This means, though, that Whites has consistently used this flash as it is up, so Cyanide again has a target.
Yeah, the farming still, again, Uzi just starting to edge that lane, but remember, Pushu did come away from it. They got that dragon. The global gold is kind of there, and he had a hand in that first blood earlier on, so it's not the end of the world. He hasn't gone for the triple Dorans either this time around, which set him behind so much with Ashe in the previous game. Soaz back in this top lane again. These two guys are monsters when it comes to the team fight.
See what Pushu can do here, trying to keep himself at bay. Finally gets Yellowstar back in that lane, and he starts to show that aggression, trying to bait him into possible bad fight. Tabe stays on the outside, and I think they win that one.
Yeah,
on
Yellowstar is not even level 6, but it seemed like he was baiting for a Solar Flare. At that point, Pushu just took a ton of free harass, and the lane is getting a little bit out of hand right here. Uzi pulling ahead of Pushu once again.
Oh, a timely ward there from Yellowstar. It's going to buy him the time to get away from this one. Cocoon is not available. Pushu's still taking low, though. You can see Chain of Corruption having to be used off. Barrier was fired off as well. The rocket's coming out from Uzi, but not quite going to find his home. But look at coming from the back.
Fnatic coming in hard with Aatrox and Orianna.
X-Pack just on the outside. He's still in the wing. They see him. Cyanide goes in for a full pop-up. He gets him. He continues to go. The double kill for Cyanide. Having another great early game on Aatrox. Looking for the triple. He's going to give it over. Oh, actually, the red buff.
He tried.
Trying to be a nice guy.
Even so, four kills for Cyanide, and this is Fnatic's counter to Royal's plan. They know Royal's going to be aggressive, so they sit back, and then they attack. Notice how this fight is between Fnatic turrets, and they had Royal outnumbered. It was a trap that Royal fell into. It was predictable, and it was executed by Peke and Cyanide.
Crazy, crazy stuff coming out of Fnatic. Managing to counter themselves, get back in it. While that was all happening, Soaz actually defended out that mid lane turret up against Godlike and Whites as well. So Fnatic doing work, once again, taking that early kill lead. But we do see Godlike, once again, off in that top. They got that turret down earlier on, and now they're starting to put the pressure back on again.
I think the big difference between this game and the last one, as far as Fnatic's lanes are concerned.
Hello.
Hello, Godlike.
Didn't
as far it. As the lanes are concerned, are actually how passive Fnatic is approaching them. In game two, Cyanide, you're not going to go back to base, man. Just get out of there.
He's baiting him.
I want to tell a story. No, but really, it's because in game two, Fnatic was trading more with Royal instead of only focusing on farm and farm and waiting for traps. When Fnatic is only focusing on farm, the farm differences are much more slight from Royal over top of Fnatic and allows better traps to be set, because since Fnatic is not allowing themselves to get harassed by Royal, it's almost daring Royal to be ever more aggressive, because that is their natural tendency in games. And Royal is falling for it. That way, when Fnatic gets the kills back, they are more meaningful because they're actually pulling ahead in gold.
And like Yellowstar said in the video, the Fnatic brand is pushing as much as possible. And once you get an Aatrox that bad, he is going to be able to crush down turrets. But they got to be careful. That's four kills now, and the only four onto Cyanide. It's not bad for this early part of the game, but that's four assists to Puju, and he's going to need those kills.
Look at the movement on the map there. Royal Club, four members coming down towards this bottom lane. Fnatic have three there, but you can see Peke is a long way away. So as he's starting to head down, but he's going to be too late. Royal Club are all over this tower.
There's a turret there, but I don't think Royal sees it. They're saying, we're going right for the champions as they move into this. Yellowstar on the backside, they're being held off at Soaz, creeping in from the side here, and Peke is very far off. So this could be a long initiated fight, but they're both going to back out with the wards.
Yeah, Royal has very good pink ward control because they fell for one of Fnatic's traps earlier. And Fnatic did rotate the long way around for this one, but they actually didn't lose farm during any of that maneuvering by Royal. So despite the four-man roam from Royal, the dive was decided against, and that actually favors Fnatic.
So blue buff finally being picked up for Whites. It's his first one, actually, of this game. And, well, Royal Club, with that dragon available, are all in the river area. Fnatic are close by, but I don't think either of these teams are interested in it just yet. It seems to be towers they're focusing on.
Big level 11 breakpoints right now for the solo laners. Peke is the only solo laner in the game right now to be level 11. Soaz isn't close, Godlike isn't close, and Whites isn't close. So if Fnatic can force this team fight in the next 45 seconds or so and Peke lands a good shockwave, it would be an advantage for Fnatic.
We'll see if they position for it. Right now, everybody is out of the top lane. That definitely spells the dance, D-man. The wards are down, but right now, that coverage is for Royal.
Soaz just went back and completed that Sunfire Cape. He's going to want to get that Let's Bounce and get up in Royal's face. Not too sure whether they're going to stand around for it. There you can see all of Royal Club backing away from this one. This may be Fnatic outpositioning Royal and pushing for that dragon early.
And as far as small item completions go right now, Fnatic is worlds ahead. So it's only a 2,400 gold lead, but because the Sunfire Cape, the Boots of Mobility, Double Thorns, and Spirit of the Ancient Golem on Cyanide, and the Athene's Unholy Grail on Peke are finished, they are worlds stronger than Royal if they catch the right team fight.
Seems like they definitely consider Royal's team fighting ability, though. Being up that much, being up four kills, they know they have a gold lead, but they aren't fighting this.
I think they're a little bit scared of Uzi, to say the least. He's 30 minion kills ahead of Pushu, and even though he's just a level 8 Corki, the missile spam, if Fnatic traps themselves in the Dragon Pit, might take them low enough. Specifically against Gragas as well, they could just get blown away.
Just off at the side, Tabe getting caught out there. Cyanide having to back away from this one. He's going to go straight into Uzi. His Bloodwell is available. They will not want that papped. And you can see immediately the defensive ball being used. This may be Fnatic having to give up the dragon.
Ooh, there's a quick flash in and the stun coming up from Godlike. Soaz is trying to bounce towards Uzi, but he's just taking too much damage. And it is the burst. The Sheen coming out now at 13 minutes for Uzi, doing some big damage. And it looks like Royal takes over Fnatic's jungle.
And the shockwave by Peke did not hit many in that one. That's why Royal seems so healthy right now. But still, everyone's still alive. They're flashing low. Royal forcing right now.
Yellowstar still looking to try and land that ultimate. Actually, I'll tell a lie, he just used it a moment ago. Now that you see Royal Club, they still want to come in for this. I'm not sure this is a good choice by Fnatic.
They want to steal at the very least.
They're putting that dragon right out to be smited. It's very low going in. It is going to go to Lucky. They will not continue to engage. They do. They go on to Xpeke, but it's not going to be enough. They stop down Godlike. Everybody from Royal is just on the heels of Fnatic, but not enough to kill.
Fnatic teetering on the edge. They are so low on health. They have to run like the wind because you can see Royal coming in for this one. White wants to get that barrel, and it's going to be off cooldown in just a couple of seconds.
But how much is Fnatic actually going to lose off this one? They already lost the dragon. So many of them have to go back to base and shop. Royal is going to push strong up this mid lane.
This turret will be in their eyes. It's going to go down. Minion wave just behind, sitting atop them. Are they backing? Are they waiting to go in? Zoaz, you guys have to
back.
That
would be very aggressive. But the dive comes in. Fnatic from behind.
Oh, push you. And just the dodge out there.
Oh, they do!
He's on the tower. You can see them locking up.
Oh, my God.
I do not believe Fnatic just managed to turn that fight on its head from nothing. Looking at it slow. Cyanide, he's already got 5 kills. Can he make it 6? He's going to lock on. Slam down. One more shot. They're going to give it Zoaz. Good God, what just happened?
That was Fnatic laying another brilliant trap against Royal. They know Royal is going to dive. There is no way they expected Fnatic to be waiting. They got the flank, and they punished again.
Now they're flexing their muscles. The solar flare to come in from Yellowstar to even say, Whites, if you come close, you're going down. Cyanide's going to take this one out. They grab a huge lead there, 5,000 gold.
And this is just huge. Look at how White's completely committed to Pushu because he didn't expect 3 people on Fnatic to still be waiting. Look how low Peke and Zoaz were. Total surprise attack. Royal thought they were in a 5v2. Wow. They were actually in a 5v5, and it burned them.
The balls to play, make that play when you're 2-0 down with everybody so low on health. You saw Peke's shockwave was up, used it off that side, forced it. Yellowstar got in there. Absolutely crazy, crazy stuff. 8-0 now, Fnatic, a 4,000 gold advantage. The first time, really, they've had such an advantage against Royal Club. What can they do with it? Royal Club right now still continuing to keep that pressure down. The bottom turret being pushed.
And something that's still similar is Ozzy started this game dying a fair bit. He's 0-2, but yep, his farm is substantially ahead of Pushu. This game, though, it is a much larger gold lead for Fnatic, and I feel like for the first time in this series, Fnatic's really pulling off their hide in the rush play style.
To Pushu's credit, that is a hard ultimate to hit. Trying to go for that chain of corruption just to the side, and he misses off. 25,000 right now to 21.6. We see him pressuring down mid lane here. Looks like Royal will be able to get more global gold. No. Actually, yeah, just pushed off by Cyanide.
The fear is coming in from Royal right
Absolutely.
Now.
Absolutely.
It's actually become, it's come to a point where they are scared of where Fnatic might be. And I think as soon as a team gets in that mindset against Fnatic, you lose because you think they are everywhere. And they usually are.
Oh, well, they've caught on to Lucky. They managed to get the piercing arrow. Yellowstar can't get the steal on towards him. Great knockback there from White, trying to keep them up. Hey, Lucky's going to be the focus target once again. He can't repel from this one. Now Peke finally gets himself a kill. Uzi realizing he's going to go and try and steal his own blue buff, but Fnatic pushing the tower.
Yeah, there's only 2 people right now defending that turret from Royal, and Uzi desperately tried for the blue buff. You got to run away, Corky.
They know he's there. They continuously go for him. Uzi will grab that up, head down towards the bottom side, but Fnatic now to kind of take a breather, figure out what's going on around the map. We do see Cyanide 5-0-2, the assist train behind him, 1-0-5, 0-0-7 for Pushu. These guys have yet to die in this third game in the series.
But like game 2, when Fnatic get in the kills, they're 9-0 up.
Right.
But they don't get an objective afterwards. They didn't manage to push a tower again. They, all 4 of them ran towards that blue buff. It was already gone. They were too late. They could have pushed the mid.
That's true.
They're very close to taking this game over. Right now, Royal just pulled ahead 2-1, but this is such a better situation for Fnatic because when Tabe tries to get vision back, he dies.
Bing, bang, boom, one after the other. A 10th kill up onto the board here. 20 minutes for Fnatic.
I think the Let's Bounce was a little over the top from Zoaz there, maybe. I'm pretty sure Tabe was dead already. Didn't really need it, but let's look at the items. Oh, I tell a lie. We're going to catch on Lucky once again. He's 0-3 already. It's going to be 0-4. He's going to get locked down. Who will they give it to? It's going to be Pushu.
And once Royal starts getting picked off one at a time, they can't pull off their playstyle. Royal needs to be able to group up and dive turrets. Everything they've been trying to do has backfired for them. Maybe this one, though, because Godlike has Zoaz in a bad spot.
A little too deep for Zoaz. The Let's Bounce, like you said, D-Man, it was used on Tabe, so he's going to be forced to walk out of this one. Cyanide looking to help. He does have the jump he needs. Looks like they'll be able to hightail it out of here.
Pekka is heading down the side. The rest of them are sticking around the top there. They see the defensive ball just coming out towards Cyanide. They're keeping them at bay. Now Pushu and Yellowstar are starting to head down here, and Royal realize it. Pekka being aggressive, trying to keep the pressure on. Top two, it does go down while this is happening. Fnatic maneuvering for a fight.
There's definitely a different build here coming out of Pekka. He goes for the Haunting Guise after the Athenes, but the pressure on the mid turret is going to allow Royal deeper into that mid lane. This is actually where Fnatic pinched them into their last fight, so you can see how much they just stop and head down to something else after that.
That was actually a really good counter by Royal as well. Got in there, got that turret. So all three outer turrets now out of the way. And Royal, they just go for the objectives. They'll pick up a fight on the way.
Yeah, it is quite crazy to think that it is 11 kills to zero, which would seem like a landslide victory for Fnatic. But the gold is only 4,000, some 21 minutes into the game. A lot of that has to be just attributed to Uzi's ability to keep up his farm. Yes, he has died two times, but his Corki is going to be a mid-game force. He's actually 600 gold ahead of Pushu, despite Pushu's participation in 8 kills for Fnatic.
But you say that, but for the first time, I think in... This is the third game going, the first time ever we see Pekka ahead in gold. Apparently just.
It's huge.
In terms of farm. But he's been losing out of that lane hugely. And of course, the top lane, we see Soaz and Godlike. Soaz is finally ahead. This is the first time that Fnatic have had two lanes actually in the advantage.
It really seems that when Royal gets that early lead, the few early kills, that is the catalyst for them to keep going. Without a kill yet, they haven't been able to formulate anything. They're watching Fnatic dictate how this game works.
Yeah, right now Fnatic actually in danger of getting a little initiated on because they're trying to pick up side turrets. Soaz gets blown back.
They're going to try and put the pressure on him. Pekka is not with his fight, nor is Pushu, so Soaz is simply trying to escape here. Cyanide's going to get locked down. He jumps back away from it. Soaz has managed to walk away. Royal do not lock anyone up, and now Fnatic are grouped as a five.
That is something to mention. There is a lack of crowd control coming from Royal. They can bounce each other around and displace you, but they got to catch you after that, and you can see Soaz just walked out of a 3v1 situation. 11-0, 23 minutes in. That gold lead still in the favor of Fnatic. They've evened up those outer tier turrets. Both teams now have access to the jungle.
I also like the fact that when Cyanide picked up 6 kills, he's put it straight into an Aegis of the Legion after he made himself a little tanky and gave himself as much map mobility as possible. As far as Cyanide's style of jungling, which is mainly to enable Xpeke and Soaz, that's the best use he can get out of accidentally last hitting 6 champions.
Xpeke's just picked himself up. Leandris as the second item around. We'll see that pays dividends. White's, it's the first time we've seen him on Gragas in this matchup. Wheelstar with that Oracle just been picked up. He's clearing out those Barons. Remember, Royal have snuck into that Baron pit a couple of times. I don't think they're going to go so crazy this time around.
It was actually really good that last time we saw Lucky go down the top lane, he hooked a pink ward over his shoulder into the Baron pit, which has been cleared since. But you can see, even in death, these guys want to give themselves an advantage for their team as they come back.
And at least right now that Pushu has completed his last Whisper on Varus, it is a very strong point in the game for Fnatic. Their completed items, when compared to the completed items in Royal, do seem to be quite superior right now. You can see they're trying to take advantage of Royal's jungle. At this point, the fear is actually Royal sneaking a Baron. We know they are fearless as far as going into Smite Wars. They are doing a lot of damage. They are on wards of Fnatic, though. This could either be Royal getting back in the game or the absolute end of the game.
They spotted Pekka. He was way down that bottom lane. They do try. They thought about it. Like, nope, there is vision. Let's back out of this one. And Fnatic going to try and take advantage of this. They're running up the mid lane.
You can see that instantly Royal got in the head of Fnatic. Well, Fnatic was already in the head of Royal and said, they're backing, so we need to. We're going to lose this one. And if you looked at your watch, it was 20 minutes. That's when Royal takes the Baron, but Fnatic knew it was going to happen this time.
Yeah, that is going to be a turret down. There's also off the side there. We see Pekka continuing to push. Fnatic rotating around there. And Royal a little bit slow on the rotation here. Fnatic are going to get it first.
Yeah, and this is the dangerous spot to rotate against Fnatic. One guy goes the wrong way, and he's pushed back.
Godlike getting hit up a little bit. The ward war goes down in the tight path right between the turret and these two guys. Again, the wet noodle fight off to the side as the teams
there
size each other up.
Solar flare lands. Chain of Corruption comes in. It's lucky once again, but does manage to repel this time around. Pekka ready to wait. Bang! The shockwave goes down. They slam back on towards Uzi, but there's a lot of damage coming out from Rogue Club. They're keeping Fnatic at bay. They got the Bloodwell passive of Cyanide, but they got it back from this turret.
How did Peke have enough time to walk in there without minions? The entire team watched him remove the ball and kill Lucky. These guys are in their own heads right now, and Soaz even wants more.
Soaz has not used Let's Bounce. There it is. He's going to pop it down, gets the ball on top of his head, and they're going for Uzi. Not going to catch him. It's Godlike that turn to. One more shot to do
steal.
It. But he gets... No! Soaz gets him down. I didn't see what it was. May have been the red.
And one after the other. Now 13 kills for Fnatic. They are getting Royal to actually re-engage a little bit.
Whoa.
Soaz catching Whites once again. He's blocking his body slam.
That ward down the lane gave him the ability to do this. Slows again onto Whites. Is this body slam to get across the wall? He gets hit up with the rocket. Uzi's trying to continue with the red buff, but it gets transferred over. Double buff for Peke.
So they finally get one back in the end, but that is a lot of turrets down and a lot of advantages gained by Fnatic. The fact that it is four kills now onto Peke, the fact that they have so much gold from all of this means trouble from Royal. I think if they continue to play the way they are, we're going to see more games.
Crazy, crazy stuff. Uzi finally got himself the first kill for Royal. It is 2-0 to Royal Gaming, but Fnatic are looking very good here to make this a four-game matchup, but let's not get ahead of ourselves. We've seen these matches going back and forward over a Baron fight over some crazy objectives. Let's look at what the items are coming out. We did see that Leandre's earlier on from Peke. He's picked himself a couple of kills now and got that needs large rod. Rabadon's death gap will be coming soon, which you see Whites has completed, but Whites is starting to fall behind. Despite the fact that keeping even in farm, 0-1-1 up against a 4-0-7 is a big difference in that mid lane.
Yeah, there's no Leandre's torment right now, and what's making Peke so dangerous as far as the huge amount of magic penetration he's built up to the low amount of magic resistance that Royal's been able to build. You can actually see Soaz really just trying to initiate, flying, and he does not have any cares right now.
Almost catches White taking a drink there in mid. They do have the locket of the Iron Solari built up now. And we have to look at Fnatic's comp coming around this time. It's the good offense, good defense comp. 15-1, you found five turrets as well. That one death is on your Aatrox, on your tank who's diving. You're doing it the right way.
This is not good positioning for Royal. They are going four members up their mid. Lucky split off the side, and Fnatic are all in the jungle up behind them. They may go for this.
Fnatic has so many moves they can make right now. They could either go for a fight, or they could just rush over to Royal's inhibitor.
This is not the first time Lucky's been caught by himself, but the team may have time to walk over. They're all funneling in behind, and Fnatic knows it.
That was a misplay from Yellowstar, though. Solar Flare was used on Lucky, and the rest of the team were not on the same page. They do turn back away from this one, and Fnatic now with an ultimate down. Still gonna keep pushing.
But the minions have arrived. Fnatic can just go up the mid lane or chase in the jungle.
They got the shield on to Soaz. Tabe is gonna be forced to flash out of this one. Fnatic not wasting too much to get this out of Royal.
Every time they go for it, Fnatic not quite catching them. Royal Gaming finally using those flashes, getting away from it. Dragon is gonna be pushed, so Fnatic gonna keep that gold sliding in their favor.
Dragon going down right quick. Royal looking to push mid lane here. They have to get some aggression. Nobody's split pushing for them right now. They know they need their full five versus this team of Fnatic.
They're going Baron.
Yeah, there's a lot of big waves right now for Fnatic as well that are pushed up the side. So Royal was hoping to catch Fnatic split pushing, and now they're hoping to catch a fight. Fnatic knows they're down huge in this game, and they need to get a catch.
They hit Soaz right away. Soaz getting hit. Oh, there's Chain of Corruption comes in. Can they get the shock wave? It's a four-man shock wave. Lucky could be going down. Pushu on a roll here, and he's going to turn on to Godlike.
Godlike's in all sorts of trouble. Peke's giving chase. He's got that red buff on. He's going to get the slow. There's the triple kill for Pushu. Pushu finally found the AD carry that works for him, and it seems to be Varus. It's something he's played all season long. It's going to be a Baron for Fnatic.
The only thing they have to worry about, though, is Gragas is a great Baron stealer. Peke playing some defense, trying to secure this for Fnatic, and this is just another great fight for Fnatic. We saw that Royal was trying to get a catch. Not onto the Zac, though. That's the worst man to catch because he just bounced all over Royal.
Yeah, Peke again denying buffs. We're going to see this one more time. You attack the tank, things aren't going to go well.
Yeah, the shield came in right as the bar assault landed as well. So it was just a combo of knockups and knock around. Soaz was bouncing amongst all that, and Royal just didn't have a chance to get things off. Because Uzi was hiding in the brush, he got caught in the catastrophe that was that team fight, and he went down quick.
Peke in trouble here. Uses the shockwave, flashed out from White, coming around the backside. He's going to be Tame, though. Going to try and lock him down. Peke does have flash available, puts it down, gets the slow on towards Tame. He's got help arriving.
Zeroed out.
That is a lot of damage that Peke has. As a support, you cannot run into it.
Do not chase the Peke. He is a very dangerous beast right now. 12,500 gold. He will be picking up his death cap. And what a turnaround for Fnatic in this matchup.
This is the part of that game where people say, yeah, Ori brings a lot of utility, but man, does she also bring a lot of power. 281 to 264, 6-0 and 10. Peke finding his stride within this third match of the series. The best of five looks almost to be going to the four. Fnatic needs to close this out here. It's 30 minutes, one of our longer games in this matchup, but still 20 to 1. Coming in with that 8,000 gold lead.
And knowing that they have the super tank right now, and Soaz, the 6-kill jungler in Cyanide, and only a couple outer turrets standing for Royal, Fnatic will be looking to dive. They have the Leona support. This time Yellowstar has actually been able to pick up a Spectre's Cow, just so Gragas doesn't burst him down on the turret, just because Corki does so much magic damage. Fnatic will be looking to end this as soon as they get all the waves pushing in. Since the Baron buff still has over 2 minutes left, there is no rush for Fnatic. They know they're winning every team fight. They're up 20 kills to one. They're going to try and take this one slow.
Yeah, they're going to know they've got a big advantage. They are rotating in towards this top lane. This will be an inner turret going down. That's going to make it 6-3 in terms of turrets. Royal Club are moving up towards the top, but they're not going to try and defend this one. And why is he so? They're going to stick away. While this is happening, Soaz is keeping the push in the mid lane, and Yellowstar is just lingering off around between the two towers, seeing if he can land something, seeing if anyone's going to go a little bit too deep.
They are trying to hold that front door closed right now. Fnatic is going to be pushing it down. The wards all in favor of Fnatic, also in favor of Fnatic if they need to leave this fight. If it's going to be an extended one, they have all the vision on an exit. I don't think at 20 to 1, seeing these Gragas barrels do minimal damage to Soaz or Cyanide, they're going to be able to fight this one out.
There's around about 80 seconds left on the Baron buff, so they can keep this siege continuing. There's a giant wave coming along the bottom lane as well. Whether we'll see anyone who's going to cross there. Piercing arrows are cutting him down. Soaz is thinking of going in. Does manage to jump in. He's very big right now with that defensive ball on him. This is going to be the turret just bullied down.
Continuing onto the inhibitor, this is going to strengthen up the side lanes now, and they can take this down, and it'll also send Fnatic to the side lanes to drop more turrets.
Yeah, Pushu going full archer with his build right there. BF sword on top of his last Whisper and Bloodthirster. That's one of the big reasons Royal had to fall away from that one, despite the monster's disadvantage.
Whoa, double shockwave coming in on a godlike. This is going to put them out of position. This is going to put the game in the hands of Fnatic, and they are going to continue on.
Solar flare, chain of corruption, everything landing perfectly there this time around from Fnatic. Maybe they've unlocked the Royal Club door. We can see the damage from Peke. That's going to be a double kill. He's going to be 8-0-12 for the end of this game. Lucky once again is going to get caught out. Finally drops down. It's a surrender. And Fnatic finally pick up their first victory against the Chinese Royal Club. It's been a long time coming though.
And it was a decisive one. The Orianna first pick there by Fnatic allowed them to set traps throughout the game. Most of the early kills by Fnatic were in between their own turrets. They saw Royal's success in the first two games, knowing that Royal would come into this overconfident, and Fnatic punished well.
And that Aatrox from Cyanide once again was the catalyst. Absolutely massive at that game. You think of that bottom fight that happened that finally went in towards Fnatic's favor, could easily have gone in Royal Club's favor if they hadn't been so quick with that rotation.
Yeah, that was really Cyanide stepping up once again. I really can't wait to see